him, I love him, and when he goes, I'll follow, I'll follow, I'll follow, I will follow him, follow him wherever he may go. There isn't an ocean too deep, a mountain so high he can keep me away. I will follow him, follow him, ever since he touched my hand, I knew. A mountain so high he can keep me away from his love. I love him, and where he goes I'll follow, I'll follow, I'll follow. He'll always be my true love, my true love, my true love, from now until forever, forever, forever. I love him, I love him, I love him, and when he goes I'll follow, I'll follow, I'll follow. There isn't an ocean too deep, he can keep me away. Oh, I blame him for turning my song off early. It threw me off from his love. Too enthusiastic.
Yeah!
Yeah! Well, now let's just get things started right off here. This young gentleman actually worked in a carnival for a very long time. After the carnival closed, he built a whole theater out of the scrap. You're not going to see a single bit of that tonight, but that's what he did. Ladies and gentlemen, and all those who ain't neither, give us a minute while we bring out Petey the Puppet. Don't worry, I don't need to be back there. I'm actually a marionette, so I'm good. People are like, you're a marionette, but how? You have no strings. I'm enchanted. Can we turn it up and start it over? Oh no, you gotta start it over. I got paid to do this one time. You gotta start it over. This is a legendary performance piece I built.
Thank you. morning found him miles away. But still a million things to say. Very well, toodaloo, but now. Twilight dims the sky of love. Cut the music, hold on, cut the music! Cut it! Oh my god, they're already messing with me already. Ladies, gentlemen, all those with me, those wonderful world, blah, 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 blah. Hi! Hello?
Hi!
I have a very brief, very quick announcement to make. I have to make it very quickly because the city of Cleveland does not like when I say these things out loud, okay?
Okay.
I thought I was gonna have to say okay again. Three words that you must remember. And I hope you do remember for the rest of your life. You ready for those three words?
Yeah.
Ready? Yeah. Vote rickety rat! Vote rickety rat.
For what?
Now, children, can we say that back, please?
Vote rickety rat!
Vote rickety rat! Very good, very good. Now, we're going to do a very quick chant. Yes, we are. I know it's not a school puppet show, but it's going to act like one. Remember, all right, I'm going to do it first, then you got to do it after me, okay? It's very, very simple. Vote rickety rat. Vote rickety rat.
Vote rickety rat. Vote rickety rat. Vote rickety rat.
Vote rickety rat. Oh no, they're already messing with my microphone. Oh god.
Vote rickety rat. Vote rickety rat.
Vote rickety rat. You got to be really careful.
Vote rickety rat. Vote rickety rat.
Wait, wait, shh. The thing is, the city of Cleveland likes to send a mad gorilla after me after people say that. They might have the place bugged. And we don't know if they do, so we must be very careful. So maybe we chant it a little bit softer. Oh, rickety rat. Oh, rickety rat. Oh, rickety rat. Oh, rickety rat. Louder. Oh, rickety rat. Oh, rickety rat.
Vote rickety rat. Louder! Vote
rickety rat. Vote rickety rat. Oh no! The gorilla! You think I'm crying? It's a freaking gorilla! I'm not joking, there's a fucking gorilla back here! Oh my god!
Folks, we present to you a sentient pile of talking vomit and ask existential questions.
Oh. Good evening.
Good evening.
As, as stated, I in fact am a sentient pile of vomit. Now, you see, being a sentient pile of vomit really does raise a lot of questions that I personally can't help but ask. For instance, I'm not sure if I'm the only sentient pile of vomit. I might be. Very possible.
Tonight?
Exactly. There may be more. And it brings up the question, if I claim to be the first sentient pile of vomit, is that true? Am I really the first? Because there very well could be other sentient piles of vomit that I'm just not aware of, and they're also not aware of me. Perhaps they are. And, you know, there's lots of questions that just kind of go with that. For instance, if I'm not the first, am I unique? Am I as unique if I'm not the first? Am I unique because I exist as a pile of vomit? But the question becomes then, well, if there are other piles of vomit, and it becomes a naturally occurring thing, does that stay unique? And then there's the general question of even how. I'm not sure how, honestly. I quite literally didn't ask to be alive. I just happened to come to life one day. And with being alive, I figured I might as well learn as much as I possibly can. Because I do have this life here. And I figure, well, if I have it, I might as well use it and figure out everything I can figure. I started very simply with things like ABC, 1 + 2, and then on to advanced geometry, advanced algebra. I'd say more things, but, well, there's so much I've learned, I can't necessarily remember all I have. And so with that, the main reason that I decided to study and to better myself to a degree is I'm really, well, frankly, I'm just not sure what happens when I dry. Now, you heard me correctly. I said dry, not die. Because, you see, was that?
We love you.
Oh, well, thank you. I'd reciprocate, but I really don't know you.
Easy, brother.
So, you know, the thing is, I'm not sure what happens when I do dry. I'm not sure if I go away. Because the question then is, does vomit have an afterlife? Is drying essentially my afterlife, or do I remain sentient while dry? And then even the question then becomes, can vomit actually die? Because as I said, though I may not be the first, I am the only sentient pile of vomit I know. So I'm not sure if there is an afterlife for vomit. If we simply go away, if we're mopped up, is that then our end? Because if you leave it on the floor, it dries, but if you mop it up, it goes into water, so do I become another form? You know, I was doing one of these talks the other day, and a gentleman very rather aggressively stood up
and says, why should we listen to you? You're a literal pile of talking vomit. I looked at the gentleman, you see. I had my eye on him, you know. And I said, sir, though I may be a pile of vomit, I am a man. I am not a human man of flesh and blood, no. But a man, regardless, because I have decided to be this, you see. I have taken it upon myself to be such. In a world as such, and therefore, I'm here speaking to you now with thoughts, feelings, and emotions, and for that I deserve respect. Now, I could go on to what is respect, but we'd be here all night. So, while I am here, completely wet, I should say, because I am not dry, I'm going to continue to live this life as I most see fit. It's the life I was given. It's the life that I randomly received. I'm not sure why I'm here. I'm not sure if I have any purpose of being here other than the fact that I have come to life and gained sentience as a pile of vomit. But I'm going to use that, and I'm going to live and study and, well, not eat, because I have to see. And I think that's just fine. Thank you.
Now, dear friends and neighbors, we're going to have a little Japanese monster action.
Oh.
Fancy, right? Don't get too excited, he's from Cleveland. But we're going to have a little Japanese monster action from our dear friend Pongachu. Just give us a minute. No, there's no music to start just yet. Thank you very much. All right.
Pongachu. 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 Pongachu.
Well, I hope that was enjoyable for absolutely everybody. I know it was for me. In fact, I had some popcorn while watching. And by, just so y'all know, there is popcorn and Kool-Aid available for the puppet show
it's
for
over
free.
Woo!
I've never hasted a lackluster response to something for free. Well, we have a few more performers for your lovely evening tonight. Would y'all like to see two more performances? Just give us a second here. We're gonna bring out our next performer, another veteran of this here troupe, the lovely Miss Penelope Peanut Butter. With her rendition of Miss Otis Regret. Regrets, oh my goodness. They gave me too many free drinks, y'all. So here she, here, we're gonna set her up on the next stage over here.
Peanut Butter Penelope.
Give us a second. Paul, she was very, very tired. Please let him rest.
Thank you.
enjoy Puppets Take Over the World.
Woo!
Well, I guess you did. Well, it really is an honor. Our next and final guest, you know, this here is the very original member of this troupe from 1994. I know how that sounds. Trust me, it's a thing. Ladies and gentlemen, he actually just got back from a tour at a very strange underground theater show where he played a single pubic hair between somebody's legs.
Big sale.
Sure. Give us just a second. We're going to introduce you to the one, the only, Lion. Lion, wake up.
What was that?
Wake up, Lion, you're on.
I'm on. Oh, okay, one sec, hold up. Let me just adjust myself. Not like that, you partners. Ah, there we go. I'm coming out. You can clap, it's okay. Oh, let's see here. Let's get us a microphone, shall we? Well, all right then. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening. Well, just a few things. My name is Lion.
Hi, Lion.
Hi.
You're Lion.
I am Lion. Guess what else? Guess what else?
What?
I'm a lion. I say that, and you know, you think this used to be a joke, then it really happened. I say I'm a lion, you know. What else would I be? Then someone's like, oh, I'm lying. They're like, what are you, a tiger? Sure. Well, you know, we've been closing the shows out with me for a while. And as I said, I am technically the original member of this troupe. It's a long story, don't worry about it. You want to hit that track?
Yeah.
This is for everybody and everything and so on and so forth.
Lines everywhere.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life. When life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten. And that's to laugh and there's a smile and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chums. Just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life. Well, life's a piece of shit when you look at it. Life's a joke and death's a joke is true. Sorry. Keep feeling it. Ah, damn, I knew it was gonna mess up this part. Just remember that the last joke is on you. Always look on the bright side of death. Or just before you draw your terminal breath. Man, I ain't never done this, but hold up. Remember that the last laugh is on you. So always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
much for coming to Puppets Take Over the World! Thank you all so much for coming. Just so you know, if you'd like a t-shirt, I have them over here. I drew it, I designed everything. They're $20, let me know. Thank you!
Nate fucking Puppets, ladies and gentlemen, Nate Puppets, okay? Puppets Take Over the World.